So hello everyone, welcome again. Today in this video, I am going to share a topic that is female intimate hygiene or V health. So it is very important topic and it is a very sensitive topic. Before starting the topic, I want to say something that in this presentation, which I am going to give you, in this presentation, there are some sensitive pictures, but it is very important for all the females in the world. So in this presentation, I am going to cover all the important concept, that is why female intimate hygienic condition is very necessary for the females, and what are the things that females are going to do which leads to the harmness of their intimate hygiene, which leads to the harmness of their private part. So all the female intimate hygienic conditions which should be followed by any female is covering in this video. I'm going to cover all these things in this video. And before starting the presentation, here are something that is you can see that there is a picture which representing here. In this picture, what is appearing actually, this is a female reproductive system. Here you can see these are two ovaries which are present on the left and right side, and these are the infundibulum tubes, or you can say even the fallopian tubes. And in the middle there is a region, that is uterus, where the baby kept inside the body of a female during pregnancy month. And these uterus is covered by different types of linings, that is endometrial lining, mesometrial lining and perimetrial lining. So these are the female reproductive system. And in the last, at the end of this uterus, there is a part that is known as a cervix. And below the cervix, there is a part which is known as vagina. And vagina is covered by vulvar folds. So vulva is completely different from vagina. Keep it in your mind that vulva and vagina both are different things. They are not same things. And what happened during different conditions, or during in the last years, or we can say since 10 a year ago, approximately 10,000, or you can even say 1 lakh years ago, people mostly believe that female is the only cause which gives birth to someone. Means a female have some divine power which leads to the pregnancy of another generation, which leads to the pregnancy of someone. Actually, they were not known about the men's sperm's function during pregnancy or in the birth of any child. They only think that it is a miracle which is creating by any female, because female have a divine power which leads to the formation of a new one, which leads to the giving birth of someone else, which is a totally miracle for them. So they said that this part, which is now known as female external genitalia, at that moment, approximately 1 lakh years ago, people think that it is a very beautiful portion of any female, and they call them as yoni, and they represented them with a different symbols, like they representing them with a triangle, with flowers, or some fruits shapes are also represented and female external genitalia are also represented by the shape of any fruit, like pear, for example, any pear. So at that moment, people think that only female are the cause which leads to the birth of someone, and they worship this part of a female because they think that it is the only thing by which they are inhabiting this earth. Only the female is a main reason for that. That's why they worship the female external genitalia. Many girls prefer to say them like toady or even smooching. So different types of names they said this female external genitalia, but now it is known as female external genitalia. So different things are represented in this female external genitalia. Different parts are there, like vulva and vagina are both are different things. I'm not going to share detailed information of the female external female reproductive system, like ovaries, fallopian tubes. I'm not sharing all these things. I'm just giving an highlight on the vulva and the vaginal portion. So before starting the presentation in this video, I want to give the reference point, reference pages. So I am talking about all the video which will be based on this article, that is Role of Female Intimate Hygiene in Vulvo-Vaginal Health, Global Hygiene Practices and Product Uses. This article was published in Women's Health of the Journal of Sage of UK University, and this journal is a valid journal, and this article date received on 13 Jan 2017, and it was revised again on 21st April 2017 and accepted on 14 August 2017. So this is a reference point. Many authors are included inside it. Many authors are giving their contributions during this paper formation, like for example Sarah D. Sesslin, Dr. David Hicks, Dr. RB, they get together on a committee, that is ICMJE, and on that committee they concluded that the article, that the reference in the, that the point which is published in this article, all are valid, all have providential proof, there is no criticism regarding it, there is no critical condition, so there is no criticism condition. So all these things were included in this paper is totally valid, totally refined and totally investigated. There is no matter of criticism, all matters are resolved. So this is a reference point. And another reference point is our V-book, A Doctor's Guide to Complete Vulvo-Vaginal Health, which is wrote by Elizabeth G. Stewart, MD. So this is my reference point for this topic, which I'm going to cover in this presentation through video. So let's have a look on female external genitalia, that is vulva. As I said before, that vulva and vagina both are different things. Here you can see in the picture that this portion represents the female part, female private portion. And in this, I am going to give pressure on the point, pressure on the thing, that is vulva. So here you can see in the middle, there is a portion which is known as vulva. So basically vulva included what? Vulva included mainly five things. Many other things are also included inside vulva, but these five things are mainly composed are vulva of female's vulva. Okay, so these five things are, firstly labia majora, which are the upper lip, or you can say outer lip, which are present on the outer side. These are big lips. When you touch your vulva, then you can see these lips are big in size, so that's why they are known as labia majora. Labia means lip and major means big lip, big. That's why it is known as labia majora. Second thing is labia minora. This is labia majora, actually it is represented here, and this is labia minora. Labia minora is the external infoldings, or you can say external lip, internal lip, which is present inside the labia majora. So labia majora are the external lips and labia minora are the internal lips, which are present inside the labia majora. And in the labia minora, you can see that on the upper side, when you touch your vulva, then there is a very pointed structure which is known as clitoris. And clitoris is a main purpose. Clitoris main purpose is creating sexual arousal, or it leads to the sex drive. So it is very important because here different nerve endings, that is sensory nerves ends here. Approximately 8,000 nerves are ending and here in the penis. You can say if we compare the penis sexual arousal or penis, you can say penis nerve endings, then if there are 4,000 nerve endings, then the double nerve endings are occur here. So here approximately 8,000 nerve endings are occur at the clitoral region. And when you touch it, then these sensory nerve endings feel pressure. That's why it leads to the arousal of, it leads to the orgasm, and because it sends the signal to the brain. And you can see below the clitoris, there is an opening which is known as urethral opening. So here you can see this is urethral opening. Urethral opening is basically the opening from where the urine can pass out. And on the both side of the urethral opening, there are glands which are known as a skin gland. And below the urethral opening, there is another opening that is known as vaginal opening. You can see here, this is a vaginal opening. And vaginal, on the either side of vaginal opening, there is another gland which is known as Bartholin's gland. Bartholin's glands are known as greater vestibular glands, and skin glands are also known as lesser vestibular glands. So here you can see Bartholin's glands are greater vestibular glands, and skin glands are lesser vestibular glands. So all these things are included in the vulva of the female. Okay, so next thing is that vaginal opening is not completely open. Actually, it is partially covered by a thin membranous structure, that is hymen. Actually, people think that hymen is the indicator of virginity, but it's not, because there are many reasons due to which hymen get torn. That for example, if you are a gymnastic person, you are doing cycling, or you are a sports person, then it or during sexual violence, actually many a times hymen get torn. That's why it is not a pure indicator of virginity. And before hymen layer also have some pores. That's why menstrual bleeding comes out through hymen. And vaginal opening, you can say it's not totally or completely closed, so there is a partial opening for that is hymen, due to hymen. So it is all about the vulva. And above the vulva, you can see there is a fatty tissue pad. You can see where hairs are grown. That is known as Mons pubic. Actually, Mons pubic, Mons means mountain and pubic means hair. So there is a mountain of hair. There is a elevation in the body from the clitoris region, from the vulva region. So that's why it is known as Mons pubic. Pubis, it is a thick fatty tissue pad, and it helps, it acts as a cushion during sexual intercourse. That side is very important for a female. And hair, function of hairs is also very important, which I'm going to cover in my further slides. Different type of glands are also present in the vulva, that is sweat glands and sebaceous gland. Here you can see glands are present in the vulva, that are sweat gland and sebaceous gland. And the structure is very important. Tissue structure is very important for vulva and vagina. I'm going to cover again all these things in my next video, and female external genitalia and vagina all will be covered in the next video. Thank you, friends.